Wilkeswood High School. This is Mrs. Jablonski. I just wanted to formally welcome you back for the 2020-21 school year. Last week, we put together a ninth grade orientation for all of our incoming freshmen, where we talked all about virtual learning and what to expect. After watching it, we thought that maybe some of our upperclassmen might have questions as well. So we put together this presentation that we hope that you'll watch to answer some of your questions about the way the daily schedule is going to work and what our general expectations are for students during the time period for virtual learning. We hope you enjoy it. We can't wait to see you on Wednesday, and welcome back. On behalf of Mr. Mastroserio and myself and all of our faculty and staff here at Spotswood High School, we just want to welcome you back again to the 2020-2021 school year. Today, what we're going to be discussing is what to expect from virtual learning. Virtual learning is new for almost all of us. We had a little bit of an experience with it in the spring, but I think what you'll find is that we've made some adjustments for the fall that are going to be really easy to understand, but require a little bit of explanation. So our purpose today is kind of to go through those expectations with you so you know exactly what to expect from the first day of school. So our schedule today is we're going to talk about virtual learning FAQs and guidelines, along with what the daily virtual learning schedule looks like. We'll also touch briefly on attendance requirements, extracurricular eligibility, and then finally academic integrity. So, what is class going to look like under the virtual model? So, every day you're going to follow your daily schedule, which you can find in Genesis. Class will take place through Zoom, and your assignments will be posted and turned in via Google Classroom. So this is what the daily schedule looks like. It runs from 7:35 a.m. until 2:16 p.m. every single day of virtual learning. So what that means is during period one, if for example you have chemistry that class period, you would get logged into that teacher's Zoom meeting at 7:35 a.m. The teacher would conduct class from 7:35 a.m. until 8:13 a.m., and at that point, you would log off of that teacher's Zoom. Now, we have 4 minutes of passing time, so that's your time, even at home, to take a little walk around, to use the restroom, to get a drink or a snack, and then at 8:17 a.m., you're going to log into your period two class Zoom. And that would last until 8:55 a.m., and we would continue to repeat that throughout the daily schedule. You'll notice that on period 5-6 or 6-7, you have either one class or the other. As upperclassmen, you all know that in your schedule, you won't be double booked for those two periods. You'll either have a class 5-6 or a class 6-7. And same with period 7-8 or 8-9. Then you'll notice that we have lunch. And again, that's your time to have lunch at home. All of our staff and all of our students will be taking a lunch break at the same time. After lunch, we have two more periods, period 10 and 11, and then we end the day with what's called office hours. And we'll talk about what office hours mean a little bit later on in this presentation. But basically, we've structured your virtual learning day so it looks as similar to a typical day in school as possible. All right, so what kind of technology do you need at home? So in order to participate in distance learning, you need to have a laptop, Chromebook, or tablet that has a camera and a microphone and has the capability of running Zoom. If you don't have one of those devices or have access to a device that you can use for virtual learning, it is imperative that you reach out to myself or Mr. Mastroserio as soon as possible. I can't guarantee at this point that we'll be able to get you one for the first day of school, but we should be able to get you one. So please, please, one to loan. So please make sure that you are reaching out to us as soon as possible if you don't have access to a device. One of the things that we learned from the spring is that we do not recommend that you use your phone for distance learning. It's okay in a pinch to do a Zoom meeting or to do a homework assignment here or there. But what we really found was that students struggled that tried to do all of their schoolwork on the phone. So it's okay here and there, but in order to do your very best work during distance learning, we highly, highly suggest that you have a laptop, Chromebook, or tablet. And of course, it is imperative that you have the ability to run Zoom. All right, so how can you access your online accounts? So as you all know, our Spotswood email is run through Google. And as well, Google Classroom is obviously run through Google as well. So you'll log into your email. You'll be able to log in to Google Classroom through that email. And it is absolutely so important that you check your Spotswood email daily. That is the number one way that your teachers are going to be communicating with you. So every single day, you absolutely must check that email address. Okay, how can I ask a teacher for help? So what if I'm confused about something? One of the things that we heard from our students from the spring was that they needed more assistance with assignments. And so what we've done this fall is we've added office hours to our schedule. Office hours is a time for students to pop in virtually for check-ins, to ask questions, to get extra help about something that you might be confused about. And we urge you to use this time to the best of your ability. That's why we've built it in for you. You may find that teachers might run study sessions during this time or offer study sessions during this time as well. But all of your teachers will be having virtual office hours daily. All right, so how will you know tomorrow, Wednesday, how to get into Zoom for the first day of school? And the answer is check your email. All of your teachers will be sending you an email with the Zoom info for the first day and then Google Classroom information for how to join their Google Classroom. On that first day, they'll be talking about class expectations. They'll also talk with you about the Zoom procedures for their class. And where you can expect to find assignments in Google Classroom. So it's absolutely important that you have checked your email so that you can be a part of that conversation. Okay, how will I get my books and other materials? So this Thursday, September 3rd, and Friday, September 4th, from 12 to 3 p.m., we are scheduling book pickup. So if your last name starts with A through L on Thursday from 12 to 3, you're going to come to school and pick up your assigned textbooks. If your last name starts with M through Z, you're going to come and do the same thing on Friday. Our book pickup will look exactly the same way that it did when we did book drop-off in the early summer. So you'll pull around the front of the school, you'll give your name, we'll ask you to pull around the side by the gym, and a bag of books will be waiting there for you. These books have all been signed out to you. They will have to be returned to the school. So you'll want to make sure that you treat them with care. As well, if you're taking certain courses that require you to have materials other than books, such as, for example, an art class, you may find that you have things like art materials as well that you need to pick up. Now, your teachers know that you don't have your books for this coming school week, so they'll be working around it. But our expectation is that when you log in on Monday for virtual learning, that you'll have all of the materials that you need in order to participate in class. All right, so one of the frequently asked questions that I get from students is, do I have to go to the Zoom classes? And the answer to that is yes. So unless there is some kind of a mitigating circumstance or reason why you can't be there. So in that case, you just need to let administration or let your school counselor know what's going on. Otherwise, we expect you to be in school just like we expect you to be in class typically. So just like in a regular school day, our expectation is that you're going to be in school and be participating in class. The same holds true for these Zoom virtual classes. So if you have a special situation or a family situation going on that we need to know about that we can help to support you in, please, please let us know. But unless there's extenuating circumstances or an emergency, the expectation is that you will be in each one of your Zoom classes. All right, so let's talk about some virtual learning guidelines. Now, these are just general guidelines that our teachers will be using during virtual learning. They will explain these guidelines to you on the first day of school, and they may also add a couple that relate only to their class or the way that they're structuring their particular classroom. So we'll want you to be on time and come prepared. So as you may know, it can take a couple minutes to get logged into Zoom. So make sure that you give yourself that extra time. Come prepared with all of your materials ready to go and at an arm's reach. You'll need to set your Zoom name as your first and last name. Use your SPSD email for your Zoom. You'll need to show your face for attendance and during class. So for example, unless there's a reason why your camera would be turned off, your camera needs to be turned on during class so that we can monitor you and so that your teacher can help you. And also it helps to stay focused as well. You need to keep an appropriate Zoom background at all times. You should keep your microphone muted unless you're speaking in class. So, and the reason for that is if you've ever been on a Zoom call where everybody had their microphone and it was not muted, it's really hard to hear people. So that's part of Zoom etiquette, is to keep your mic muted unless you are the one that's speaking. We highly suggest that you use headphones if that's possible. It just helps to block background noise for yourself. And it also helps to block background noise when you are speaking for other people, for your classmates, so that they can hear you really well. And then finally, we also suggest that you set up a quiet workspace, if possible, a place where you are going to be doing your schoolwork. The best place is the kitchen table or dining room table, where you can spread out, and that's your academic space. When you designate that space in your house, it tells your brain, you know, now is the time to work. I'm sitting at my desk and I'm ready to go. So we highly suggest that you do that if it's possible. All right, so we just want to review a couple of policies with you. The first is attendance. So we are keeping to our school attendance policy. You need to be in class so that we can mark you present. If you are not in class and you can't be there because, for example, you're sick or you're absent for another reason, your parents still need to call the attendance line and call you in as being absent and unable to attend class. That's very, very important. Because again, you should be monitoring your attendance. We don't want you to have more than 16 absences to the class because you could potentially lose credit for that class. We don't want to see that happen. So we are keeping to the attendance policy. It's imperative that you are there so that we can take attendance. And also because the research shows that when you are there, physically there in class, students that have great attendance do better in school, not surprisingly, than students that don't. So we really absolutely need you in school, in class. All right, extracurricular eligibility. You all as upperclassmen know this already, but we just want to remind you that our Board of Education policy states that students who fail two or more classes in a marking period are ineligible to participate in extracurricular activities in the following marking period. So again, make sure that you are monitoring your grades, that you're checking them in Genesis and reaching out to teachers if you're not doing as well as you feel like you could be to get extra help or get clarification, because we want everyone to be eligible for extracurriculars. And then finally, we wanted to reinforce the idea of academic integrity. Distance learning requires a lot of trust. So it requires our teachers to trust our students that the work that you are submitting is your work and your work alone. Our expectation is, unless your teacher tells you otherwise, the work that you are submitting is your work and your work alone. So if you are confused about whether working with another person or taking another person's input on your assignment might be a violation of academic integrity, I highly suggest that you speak with your teacher first. It is better to ask permission than to have to beg for forgiveness on academic integrity issues. Please also be mindful that if you are found in violation of the school's academic integrity policy, there are consequences, and those consequences begin with a zero on the assignment, whether that assignment is a test or whether it's just a nightly homework. So please make sure that you are being mindful of that and that you're submitting work that represents who you are as a student. All right, so last, we know that you have lots of questions about hybrid learning. And we're not going to talk about that today because hybrid learning is coming up in a couple of weeks. But as we get closer, we'll put out a similar what to expect for those new circumstances. So until then, we are so excited to see you on Wednesday. We are excited to see you log in for class and be a part of a virtual classroom. Our teachers have been working hard. They're excited to see your faces, Mr. Mastroserio, myself, and all of our staff as well. So we can't wait to see you on Wednesday. Welcome back to this school year. If you have questions, please reach out to us. Otherwise, we can't wait to see you on Wednesday, Chargers. Bye, everyone.